O Lord, open our lips, and our mouths shall proclaim your praise. We come before your presence, you who are common to us all. God in the midst, come close to us and help us to come close to you, as for a fraction of time we step back from the activities and demands of the day. So if, as this day goes on, we forget you, do not forget us, O God. Amen. Holy Wisdom, delight of our God, you open our ears, we hear your word. You enter deep into the being of humanity. Foolish to the world, you unmask our follies. You are a shelter to us by day, and a steady flame throughout the night. You lead us through turbulent waters, and bring us safe to dry ground. You open the mouths of those who are mute. You loosen the tongues of infants in their cries. A little child takes us by the hand and leads us to freedom and truth. Holy Wisdom, delight of our God, you open our ears. We hear your word. Glory to God, source of all being, eternal Word and Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. A short reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Long ago, God spoke to our ancestors in many and various ways by the prophets. But in these last days, he has spoken to us by a Son, whom he appointed the heir of all things, through whom he also created the world. He is the reflection of God's glory. As we prepare to listen to Canon Bruce's reflection, let us pray. Spirit of Wisdom, take from us all fuss, the cluttering of noise, the temptation to dominate by the power of words, the craving for certainty. Lead us through the narrow gate of not knowing, that we may listen and obey, and come to a place of silence and stillness, of true conversation and wisdom.
To celebrate the joy of Eastertide and the start of opening up from lockdown, I'm reflecting on strange and sometimes funny things that happened to me during the 40 years as a full-time parish priest. Last week it was christenings, this week it's weddings. I can't recall the youngest couple I married, but I do remember marrying a girl who I found out was still only 16 to a sailor who was only a year or two older. The wedding of the oldest couple I married was relatively recent, not long before I retired from full-time ministry. The bride was just over 80 and her groom was 84. They'd been friends for years and often gone on holiday together since both being widowed. It was a wonderfully happy do, with a congregation largely made up of senior citizen friends. I also remember a few weddings involving a mini crisis. On one occasion, the bridegroom and the best man stood up and came forward as the bride processed in, but the groom suddenly fell to the ground. He had made the mistake of thinking that a few stiff drinks would help him overcome his nerves, and he was out for the count. We had to get him up and sit him quietly until he came round completely and we were able to carry on. Another time, I went to check with the best man that he had the ring already. He went ashen white and realized he'd left it at home. He dashed off before I could stop him and was in his car to drive all the way from Loxheath to Gosport and back to fetch the ring. I knew we simply couldn't wait for his return, as I had another wedding to do an hour later. So I went over to the vicarage and borrowed Angela's wedding ring, which was used during the service. When the best man got back, just after the end of the service, the forgotten ring was blessed and the groom placed it on his bride's finger. As far as wedding outfits go, the strangest one I remember was at Holy Trinity Fareham in the late 60s, the time of the Beatles and Flower Power. On that occasion, both the bride and groom wore identical, but very fashionable, pale green trouser suits. The funniest, though, was at my church in Ashford, Kent. At the rehearsal, I'd asked the bride if her father was going to give her away, but she seemed rather unsure, as he apparently lived in Holland and wouldn't make his mind up whether he was coming or not. On the day of the wedding, as she got out of the wedding car, a taxi raced in and her father got out, dressed in a full-scale red and black Hell's Angels outfit, ready to give his daughter away. The faces of the choir boys and girls at that service were an absolute mixture of shock and hilarity. I won't say much about our own wedding, which was conducted by the bishop at St. Peter and St. Paul Fareham on the 1st of April, 1967. Except to say, of course, that as I lived in the curate's house next door to the church, I was a very easy target for jokers. So it was no surprise when I opened my front door on the morning of the wedding to find a huge notice pinned up, "All fools wishing to be married, apply here today." Finally, just for fun, a brief wedding story. A little girl sitting with her mummy at her first ever wedding said, "Mummy, did the bride change her mind?" "Why do you say that, dear?" asked her mother. "Well, she came in with one man and went out with another." Happy Eastertide.
Throughout this day, enliven our minds, inspire our conversation, inform our decisions and protect those we love. And should today bring what we neither anticipate nor desire, increase our faith and decrease our pride, until we know that when we face the unexpected, we do not stand alone. Amen. Let us pray the prayer that Jesus himself has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God.